Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us talk about the new open source tool called Social Media Analysis Toolkit, also known as SMAT. This tool was co-launched by Amy Bevensy from Mozilla along with other contributors. This is free, intuitive and open source tool for scrutinizing online conversations. The tool is available in English and Spanish right now. The Social Media Analysis Toolkit was designed to help facilitate activists, journalists, researchers and other social good organizations to analyze and visualize larger trends on a variety of platforms. SMAT uses intuitive UX and crisp data visualizations to unpack what's being said on Twitter, Reddit, 4chan and 8chan. Also, the support to other platforms like Telegram, Parler and Cab will be available soon. All the results data result can be exported as a CSV file. Users can study everything from what's trending during a certain period of time, to who is driving the conversations, to what links are being shared the most and beyond. The tool helps to identify the trending disinformations and their sources. The tool can be accessed through this specific link. If you go here, smat-app.com. It will show you all the available options and the you will be able to generate the required reports. Tool provide different options. If you select here, timeline, hashtags, link counter, activity. The timeline functionality takes a search term. You can provide a search term here, and also obviously you can say the start date, end date, then what social media to search. Then this visualizes how often it appeared over a period of time and across platforms. Now the next one is hashtag. The hashtag functionality takes a search term and visualizes related hashtags, like list out all the related hashtags, trending hashtags. Then the link counter functionality takes a search term and visualizes what links are appearing alongside it. So it will list out all the links getting used across the different platforms. Then the next one is activity. The activity functionality takes a search term and visualizes which authors or subreddits have the most activity. So it will list out the activity list. So now if I go to the timeline, let's say I select a timeline, I'm saying like search term, let's say election, then start date and end date. I can change it if required. What platform you want, you can select Twitter, Reddit, 4chan, 8gun, those are all available right now. But there will be other support also, other tool support also. Then you can say like how this will be visualized, hourly, daily, weekly, or monthly. I'm going to daily. So once that already, you can just click on see timeline data. Yeah, it will display you timeline on Reddit. Then like whatever the platform you are selecting, it will have that graph. So even in the this graph, you can save as PNG. So you can use it for future. Also like this will show you the day wise, because we selected daily, so it will show the daily data. So how much this, where this date, the usage of that search term election is 13441. So it will show the day wise. So even you can download this as a CSV file. So like that, like other let's say like hashtags, if you go to again same thing. So if you see here, like it say like related hashtags also, how much time this hashtag is appeared and all those details. Even you can same thing, save as PNG and you can download. Yeah. So now you can set some limits and all those things here. Now if I go and change this to link counter, same way, it's like it will show you the links, appearing links. So from which site those links are appearing. The source of the links. Now again, like if I go and do that activity, it will show you the who's doing that, right? So then on Reddit, and I can select other social platform also, so it will show you the activity details also. Even you can, who is the author of that particular information, so you can download that, so that you will be easily able to identify the disinformation and the source of that, from where that information is getting driven. This tool is open sourced, so you can refer the Gitlab repository. So if you go here, so this is the Gitlab repository SMAT project. So here like multiple repositories, this is that SMAT-BE, this is the backend repository. Then if you go to that SMAT, the BUE, this is the front end repository. So yeah, so this is the front end is developed based on BUE. Then like the back end is developed based on Python and other APIs. The pub. So they are using a lot of APIs to connect and fetch the data, also exposing this data as an API. Now if I go to these details here, like view docs here. Yeah, if you go to that view docs, you can see like the base URL, how the API can be accessed. So this is the API URL. You can specify some term, then like you can say what site it should be searched. So it will give you the JSON data. Now the same way the back end, the front end, so it's like based on BUE. So you can see here some details like the staging URL also available and the master URL. This is the actual live URL, that's the stage URL. Even you can, this is open source, you can contribute that and also you can build it in on your local. Yeah, this is the useful tool. So you will be able to trace the informations in the social platforms, and you will be able to identify the disinformations and the source of those information. Also, you will be able to see, obviously see the trend of the data. So like on different platforms. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.